This is quite the undertaking to get out here for even like three or four races. So I appreciate you folks that have come out to a bunch of these things. It's been a great series so far. And, you know, I know things have changed on the fly here a little bit, but I think that's just going to increase the intensity here tonight. I think we're in for one heck of a show. So why don't we go ahead and get things started? Let me ask you all to please rise if you're able and remove your caps. I'm going to welcome in Mr. Gray Schofield from Central Florida Raceway Ministries for today's invocation. Gray?
Thank you, Ryan, if you would join me in prayer. Father, you are the God of love, mercy, and we praise you for that. Father, we thank you tonight for the staff, for the teams, Lord, for the officials and the greatest fans in the world, Lord, that are here today, and we praise you for that, Father. We pray for your divine protection upon this facility that you watch over us. We pray, Father, that you would protect our military and our first responders and let them know that we really care for them, and we thank them that all they do for us. So, Lord, again, we pray for that protection that you would watch over us, Lord. And we pray all this in the holy and the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
And now for the presentation of the Canadian and the Star-Spangled Banner, we welcome in Miss Annette Bouchard.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, say, can you see? Dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Thank you very much.
Folks, let's have another big round of applause for Annette Bouchard. She's been with us all week, singing at least the Canadian and on many nights both the anthems. We appreciate her, and I believe we will see her again tomorrow for the finale. Another strong qualifying run for this youngster in that familiar-looking car, number 36. The young 14-year-old will roll off third here tonight in the Orange Blossom. Put your hands together for Ty Fredrickson. And now to the front row for this year's Orange Blossom 100. A veteran of Florida racing in all kinds of different classes. He's put car number 21, normally driven by Derek Kelly, up on the front row tonight behind the wheel. Let's hear it for Daniel Webster, our outside pole sitter. Daniel giving that 21 a good ride here tonight. He's got a good view as they'll head down into turn number one once we get going here tonight. And now we'll introduce you to our pole sitter in the Brycon 08. Let's have a nice ovation for Nicholas Noggle. And ladies and gentlemen, if you will, a big ovation to our starter, that are going to put on a show for us here in the Orange Blossom 100. Let's hear it for all of our drivers and the crews that help get these cars prepared to go racing here tonight. Drivers, start your engines! Patrick Thomas not going to make the call here. It appears I thought I saw that car rolling towards staging as I was heading downstairs. Now we're not going to start. And here we go. Nick on the inside. Daniel Webster in that 21 on the outside. Here comes your field. They stack up off turn number four. The Orange Blossom 100. Trying to get down the inside. definitely the worst place that you can hit. And David drops down just to check there. I see movement in the cockpit, kind of a 112. And Steve Weaver Jr. with a hard hit. And good news down there on the front straightaway, we just got a report Steve Weaver Jr. is okay. The report Steve Weaver is okay down there. Good news. But a scary moment here after a ferocious start to this Orange Blossom 100. Four lead changes already in the event. I think that's about as many as we had last year, to be honest with you. And we still got a lot of laps to go. 38 complete. Ty Fredrickson, the young 14-year-old up front. Of course, his father, Dan Fredrickson, is trying to predict lane at this racetrack. A plethora of cars hitting pit road. Now Catalano and Webster join the Ryan Walters machine on pit road. Run as part of the World Series. And after the large field that attempted the ASA race, we knew a number of those teams were not going to stay for the rest of the week. We still have 20 cars here for this event. Machine has been destroyed. And that car is on fire. We need safety to turn four. And of course, as we say that, the field's still streaming through as there is fire under the hood of car number 11, David Weaver. That has all the looks of a tire gone down. Weaver's out of the machine. He's out of the machine, thank goodness. And they are putting out the fire over there. Again, bad timing with the field coming through. The safety team there, but they get the fire out, and most importantly, Weaver is out. My heart, what a heartbreaking night for the Weaver family. You hate to see that for this team of underdogs that, again, they just love to be out here to take all this in and be part of the action, and unfortunately tonight, they'll be on the Speedway video highlight reel. Steve Weaver and David Weaver out of the event. Patrick Thomas was unable to start. Track. take the championship spot away. Thank you. and let's hear it for him. Your champion of the Orange Blossom 100 and the Super Late Models during the World Series, Brent Cruz. Man, what a night for you to pick up your first Super Late Model win during the World Series. You win the Orange Blossom 100 and outduel your teammate for the championship. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. I just want to thank everybody at Toyota Racing, Mobile One, everybody that's on this crew, Donnie Wilson Motorsports, but all fast race cars this weekend, every class that you see him in, they obviously have a lot of success, and it's an honor to be able to race for him and his race team, and I'm just happy to be here in victory lane.
How tough is it to have to race your teammate tooth and nails? I saw you guys racing each other hard for like fourth or fifth in the 200, the Clyde Hart Memorial, and I'm like, why are they racing so hard? Well, this is why. Every point matters out here, and you guys were tied coming in, and you guys were racing for that title, racing like it was for the championship. It was a lot of fun to watch. What's that like, having to race your teammate like that?
You gotta race your teammate with a different mindset, right? Because you obviously want him to succeed, but you want yourself to succeed as well. So it's definitely a teammate game for sure. I felt like we raced each other hard all week, and I just want to say thank you for racing me clean, and I had a good time.
Well, you put on a thriller for us, and again, we just want to congratulate you on your big night. We'll let you go celebrate.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Brent Cruz, you're winner of the Orange Blossom 100 and your champion of the World Series.
Same could have been said for Jimmy Renfrew and team, but they've decided that they have had their fun for the week and they've headed back home to New Hampshire. Ryan loses a fifth in points. He's 66 markers out.
Jags! Get exclusive discounts when you shop jags.speedwayvideo.org. Take your garage to the next level and support the channel with your buys at jags.speedwayvideo.org.
Couple of cars from the back room because there's our runner-up in the Hoosier Pro Late Model Challenge Series out here a year ago. 29 of Chuck Tuck driving the backup Hunter Wright machine. Chuck involved in an incident a couple days ago that took his 17 out of contention. And here we go. Big field of pros. Couple of drivers. Whoa, Hayden Mowry. Wow. That's way. There goes the 54, there goes the 43. Well. They almost, I was just going to say, I think we're going to escape calamity and then it turns back. Ready to go. Here we go. Try this again. RJ Braun. Championship leaders are torn up somewhere in the middle of a 12 to 15 car pileup. The big one, the huge one here in New Smyrna. Jason Vail didn't go, and the rest of the field had nowhere to go. Heartbreaking for many. Hunter Wright, the championship hopeful. He's collected. I believe down in that mess is Dawson Sutton somewhere in car 26. I'm going to ask, if you're heading down towards turn number one, please stay away from the fence. My goodness, the wreck of the week. And you hate to see it. Lap one with a 100-lap race coming up tomorrow. Absolute pandemonium and heartbreak here at the New Smyrna Speedway. And now we hope that everybody is okay. There are some hard hits. Hunter Wright went spinning like a top through the middle of this field from top to bottom. You know he took some shots. Hunter Wright was sideways. He gathered it up, but then it looked like the 407 of Jason Vail, did he miss a shift or something there? And now there are some 12 cars, maybe more, involved. Well, folks, I've just been in communication here with race control behind me. You see the 29T, the backup machine to the Hunter Wright car. He is pulled down on the pits. Now, we do not have a lap completed. It will be a complete restart, but that was an official attempt to get the race started. No driver change will be allowed at this time. So Hunter Wright can go in the 29 and drive it, but it'll score points for Chuck Tuck tonight, as that was an official start. It's just not the start we want. So huge red flag. This is going to take a moment to clean up. So Dawson Sutton's number 26. And picked up with the double record. getting ready to try to officially get this one underway. Our second attempt at the restart. A couple of cars going to hustle to get out. Tommy Sorum and the 94. Here we go, off turn number four. The field coming back to life.
Thank you.
out of shape just a bit. Scheduled 35 here this evening. Daytona Dodge American Auto Pace Car set to leave the Speedway in the hands of the 92 RJ Braun. I thought we were going to finish off the rest of the Pro Late Model field with that. Not often do you get away with being completely sideways in front of the field and only making slight contact. Hunter Wright is making the most of a disastrous situation here tonight. Still 22 laps complete. 13 to go. Let's try this again. Hayden Mowry drifts up the track. They're already 3 wide. Hunter Wright in the 29 goes by Brody Monahan, and Brody Monahan's championship hopes literally up on the wall in a shower of sparks. Hayden Mowry in the 55, I think as it came up to speed, something perhaps after the contact from that last restart attempt was not going well. His car out of shape again, and this time it's Monahan and Mowry into the fence, and Brody Monahan looking to work his way into championship contention. May have just worked his way out of it. Mowry behind the wall as we get set to try to finish this one off. 13 to go. RJ Braun, your leader. Jason Bale in second. George Phillips in that 8 car. Nicholas Nodal and Brandon Lopez, your top 5. Here we come out of turn number 4. RJ hangs onto it. Good bit of driving there by the 92. He's up. Bale trying to shove the nose of that Ford inside of the 92. Jason Bale trying to move forward. Jason Bale, the 407, Denny. These guys all racing like it's the last lap right now, but there's still 10 to go. They dip into turn number 3. Bale getting heat from behind from the Put a new car to go. Competition last match here tonight. Phillips looking to the inside. Gentlemen, here he comes for the first time in World Series victory lane. Let's hear for George Phillips. George, come here. Oh, he's forgot something. I don't blame him. He's probably excited. George, let's get you up here at the front of the car. George Phillips again. He's going to celebrate. Get those pictures. George, come on over here real quick. Let's talk to the fans in the stands. Man, what a comeback story this is. After what we saw to you at the Red Eye, we kind of quickly jumped you up the championship list. You had issues a couple days ago. Team went back to the shop, got you a new car, and here you are in victory lane. How does this feel?
It feels amazing. It means the world to me. These guys are the best, and we never kept...
So you did... come all the way back and win, and you probably thought it was all over for you a couple days ago. So now you've got to be the favorite going into tomorrow, huh?
Yes, sir. Well, I hope we can do great tomorrow. I got confidence in the team and the car. It'll be really good.
Do you have anybody you'd like to thank?
Yes, I'd like to thank the Lord most of all, my family, all of Fathead Racing, Rawson Whitmer, Citra Safe, and Simpson.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for George Phillips, your race winner in car number 8. As he survives a wild one. And I'm sorry that cut out a little bit. There's a lot of activity down here, which messes with the signal. But I'll tell you, he's excited. And that was a heck of a race. So we're going to run back up top side here and turn things over to the voice of the Tour Modifieds, Mr. Ben Dodge.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Lights are off on the safety vehicle at the point. 2x2. They head down the back straightaway. Halfway down. Beneath the scoreboard. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Modified Tour Type Racing at its best. About to go green off turn. Thank you. front straightaway, two cars come in contact. The four of Tim Conley, the Mystic Roofing Mystic Marina car, and the number 11 of Norm Newman out of Ontario, Canada, the family fun land, Scott Reinhardt Trailer's car. Damage done to the 11 car, to what appears to be the left rear. So let's set the field for you. With 7 laps into the record books, 1 leader so far. On top of his game every time out. Symbols in an orchestra. That's now in the high-stake game of poker. These are the tour tie bonafides. Hirschman looks for back-to-back victory. Ronnie Williams is first. Thank you. unusual situation. He was a big factor in this year's series.
He's climbing out, and let's hear it for Matt Hirschman. Your race winner tonight, Matt Hirschman, car number 60. Well, Matt, I was talking to Ben before I made my way down to the track. He's already reaching in. Matt knows what to do. He's been up here a time or two. Appreciate you, Matt. I was talking to Ben, and we kind of agreed. It's Matt Hirschman season here at New Smyrna. You're back on top two nights in a row.
Yeah, I mean, I think we were better last night than we were tonight, so I think we still need to probably be better tomorrow night. You know, we got Priest will be back tomorrow night. He was real good on Tuesday, so I think we still got a room to improve. We'll take a look at everything from tonight, and that's all that's left is one more night, see if we can finish strong.
Do you feel like you have a better short-run car or long-run car for tomorrow?
We had a good long-run car tonight, but it could come down to, with a pit stop involved, it could come down to some shorter run speed and with tires on the car. So I do think we still got a little bit of work to do or try and make some improvements for tomorrow night.
And I know you don't think about points. 10-point advantage unofficially over Ronnie Williams going into tomorrow. You're going to be aware where that car is throughout the event?
I think if we do our jobs and the car should be competitive enough to be up front contending for the win, and that would take care of itself. But we got to put ourselves in a position to win, and I think that would take care of itself.
Well, you're definitely going to be one of the contenders. Congratulations, two in a row for you.
Thank you.
Matt Hirschman gets it done tonight. Let me steal that ticket back from you real quick. Thank you, sir. Matt Hirschman gets it done, trying to go for the three-peat and the championship here tomorrow night.
Go to patreon.com/speedwayvideo now.
Relative idea in shape, but the teams can still massage on the bodies a little bit as they are not template cars like the Tourmans or the late models. So a little ingenuity in the body still available to be done on these cars, which makes them look pretty cool. From afar, you know, they all look relatively the same, but you get up close and really get to looking at them, there are some unique differences in a good field of drivers. Green is out, and LJ is tied. In a good group of drivers here, they all know what they're doing out there, and it is William Parker way over the lead. Oh, LJ gets into Wayne, sends him sideways. That stacks up the field. They all check up.
for second. Bruce Bennett, the 24, the inside out there. Was going to make it. Unfortunate that he had that issue right as he came off turn number four, actually through the middle of three and four when I looked up. Caution out for the first time with 17 laps complete. First one of the week in unlimited starts. Bennett the winner here in November during the Florida Governor's Cup. Definitely knows how to get it done. We'll see if tonight is his night. This would be his first World Series win if he can outdo Wayne Parker. Tire to support him, especially on these restarts.
track, but it break down around the bottom. Like a single car, no contact issue over there. So Jane held in the 33, leaking a little bit of fluid. And then Bruce Bennett found it. So he'll let Shane know where he can go to pick it back up, put it back in the car later on. Here we go. Wayne Parker, the leader, on the outside. LJ Grimm, already a winner this week, down the inside. Field powers up in the box. Comes the 24, Bruce Bennett, Jerry Simons, and Got to give him a lane here. Right up to the back bumper comes the 72 of LJ Grant. Get it up. Black 24. Wayne's car. Chris Bennett is there. Here comes the 24. Got a great run off the corner. Here he comes, ladies and gentlemen, your winner tonight, Bruce Bennett in car number 24. Here comes Wayne. Wayne says, anybody else behind me, I wouldn't have choked. So there you go. Good sportsmanship for Wayne. I know he wanted to win this one badly, too. It's a big race for the Florida Mods here. Bruce Bennett gets it done. Bruce, come on over here. Let's have a word with the folks that stuck around. And you rewarded them with a very interesting race, and I'm sure it was interesting for you. The spin and win tonight in your first World Series win. Congratulations.
Yeah, we've tried a couple times to get a World Series wins, but I said there was oil on the track. We're the only car not set up like a fucking dump truck is why we spun. But, I mean, that's all it is to it. I mean, all these guys don't know how to set a fucking race car up, and they push all the way to the third groove. That don't win races.
No, and you showed them how to get it done by not having a dump truck. And, again, we'll put the seven-second delay on this thing for tomorrow night, but... Man, what a race, and I know you don't ever want to spin out. You never want to find the oil. Thanks for finding it so we could get the car off the racetrack. Thanks for being our guinea pig. Sorry it had to be you, but damn, made for a fun race.
I mean, I figured they'd give me my spot back when I say there's oil, and then you see Speedy dry out, but you don't get your spot back, so it is what it is. Like I said, a hell of a fucking show for the fans that were left.
Well, we appreciate you coming out, and if anyone is offended, well, you know, we'll hear about it on Facebook. But, hey, good for you, Bruce Bennett. Congratulations. And I didn't want to chance the bleeps. I'm out of bleeps. Well, folks, that's the end of night number 7 here at the World Series. And I do apologize for the language there, but the raw emotion of the race car drivers, it does spill out sometimes, and we appreciate their passion. We appreciate you sticking around, joining us here for this great night of racing and, well, some carnage too. And we'll do it one more time here during the World Series. That'll be tomorrow night at 7:30 with the Richie Evans Memorial 100, the Heart-to-Heart Prolate Model 100, and much, much more. So please get home safely. Come back and see us tomorrow on behalf of the Hart family and everyone here at the New Smyrna Speedway. My name is Ryan Stevens. I had a great time watching this dump truck, the racing with you. We'll see you here tomorrow night to close out the World Series. Get home safe, everyone.
You know, our goal is to give the customer what they want, when they want it, at the price they want to pay, and then follow it up with just the absolute best customer service. You can find the same part at 100 different places, but if you find it for less, we're going to match it, and we're going to guarantee it. We're going to ship the product same day. We are all about the customer, period. And when you have a question, the associate you're talking to, he's got a car in his garage that he's working on. So when you're talking to Jags, you're talking right to the shop.